Hey everybody, welcome to Board Online, Board Offline. Today we're bringing you the top three solo-capable crowdfunding games currently funding on either Kickstarter or GameFound. I believe all three today are from Kickstarter. These are, two of them are still currently funding while I'm filming this. One of them actually has already finished, but the late pledges are available. So this is coming out a few days later than normal. I had a get together this weekend, kind of a 24-hour gaming thing, and so just didn't quite get it done in time, but it is coming out now. You still have the ability to get involved with all of these crowdfunding campaigns. So we're gonna jump right into it. Three games means we're gonna do it in 3 minutes, starting right now. Number three is the Red Burnous, Algeria 1857. This raised $12,000, more than $12,000, 250 backers. It funds on October 7th. So still got some time to get involved with this one. Matt Shoemaker and Roberta Taylor are the designers, and it's published by Hit 'Em with a Shoe. 1 to 4 players, 1 to 2 hours. This is a war game where you're fighting against the invading French forces in Algeria in 1857. As you might have guessed, fully cooperative, so nobody's playing the French forces. You are playing your solo or with up to 3 friends, fighting against the French forces. The French forces are controlled by an AI deck. So this is designed from the ground up as a cooperative game, which means the AI should be fairly fleshed out in this game. That's pretty exciting. You're gonna be working to distribute your units across the Algerian villages effectively so that you can make sure that you're able to properly defend all the territory against these invading forces. Deck building, area control, dice rolling, and it's designed for both new war gamers and experienced ones is what it says. That's kind of that's a very wide area to cover, so hopefully it can do that. Moving on to number two, the Relics of Rajivahara, as well as the Montalo's Revenge expansion. So you can get the original version. This is a solo only game. $81,000 Canadian were raised. Over 1,600 backers. Is funded on October 1st, but the late pledges are available. Joe Slack, the designer, Crazy Like a Box is the publisher, about 15 to 60 minutes. So this is a game, it looks like it's fairly simple to learn because I feel like just by watching the Kickstarter video, I already know how to play it. You're pushing these boxes around the board and like the game starts off, it's a puzzle game. And so it starts off with things kind of stacked up in a certain way. And then your character is walking around the board, pushing things and going through portals and basically trying to find their way from the beginning, I believe, to the exit for each scenario. I think it's something like 30 scenarios. I don't know if that was in the expansion or in the base box. Regardless, it's got lots of different scenarios for you to puzzle your way through and figure out how to get out. It looks really cool, and it is solo only, which is always exciting for me. And then Myth and Goal, number one this week, is at $157,000, 1,300 backers, funds on October 11th, James M. Hewitt, Sophie Williams are the designers, Blacklist Games is publishing, 1 to 2 players. This is cool. So this is one of those fantasy football style games, 45 to 60 minutes, fantasy football style games where it's like literally fantasy, like orcs and elves, dwarves and humans. And it has a AI for you to be able to play against if you want to play solo. And that's my time. Let's finish up. And if you want to play against by yourself against an AI, you can also play head to head against a buddy. And it is the manager style system where you're managing your team. It has league play where you play through an entire year of play season. I'm not sure if you can go from season to season or if it's just a single season. Either way, the base box comes with 4 teams, and you are able to pick your team's focus, kind of their play style, which then affects the tactics available to you. You're not kind of boxed in, like it doesn't have to be the super tough and hardcore dwarfs. You could make them nimble instead, that sort of stuff. Looks pretty interesting. There's some sort of exhaustion mechanism, which seems a lot like, you can push one of your players to the brink, or you can spread out the responsibilities throughout the team, that sort of thing. I'm really excited about this one because in the past, most of the, you know, there's like two or three fantasy football style games out there right now. This one is the first one, I think, that is solo capable, and that's pretty exciting. So those are the three games that caught my eye on crowdfunding for the first half of the month. Be sure to come back midway through October for the second half of the month. And thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe, click the bell, give this video a like if you enjoyed it, if you found it informative. And until next time, if you're bored online, bored offline. We'll